Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we are going to be going over how to find the domain of rational functions algebraically. Okay, so the instructions for the examples, we are to find the domain of the following rational function. So for number one, we have the function f of x equals 14x divided by 3x plus 5. All right, so how do we find the domain of this rational function? Well, in order to find the domain of a rational function, what you're basically being asked to do is to find what values of x causes the entire expression to be undefined. So what causes an expression to be undefined is when the denominator attains a value of 0. Okay, so to find the domain of a rational function, we are simply going to solve the equation where the denominator is set equal to 0. Okay, so if you solve this equation, any x value that causes the denominator to be equal to 0 must be excluded from the domain, since inputting that value will result in an undefined output. Okay, so the denominator equal to 0, if you solve that, then you get the values that you should exclude from the domain. All right, so what's the denominator here? The numerator is 14x and the denominator is 3x plus 5. So what do we do with 3x plus 5? We set it equal to 0. All right, so let's solve this for x. This is a simple algebraic equation. We'll just subtract 5 and divide by 3, okay? So subtract 5 from both sides. We're gonna have 3x equals negative 5. And then divide both sides by 3. And then our answer is x equals negative 5 over 3. So what does this result mean? Well, this result is telling us that if we plug in x, negative 5 over 3 for x into this expression, we'll have a 0 in the denominator, which will result in an undefined output. So our answer is basically going to be the set of all real numbers except x equals negative 5 over 3. So how do we write this in a mathematical form? So our domain for f of x is the set x such that x cannot be negative 5 over 3. Why can't x be negative 5 over 3? Because it's going to cause the denominator to have a 0 value, resulting in an undefined output for the entire function. Okay, so this is our domain using an algebraic approach. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other full tutorials such as this. If you have any questions or would like to request any tutorials, feel free to include that in our comment section below this video. More clips can be found on math.serve.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.